Jay Cermak here to talk about the 2018 Facebook changes that were recently announced. Mark Zuckerberg announced that they really want to focus in Facebook back on relationships between you and your friends and family. That's the big changes here. Now, the media has talked about this, and you'll hear both sides of pros and cons. And I want to remind you that real estate has been and always will be a relationship business. So what are three things that you can do to stay top of mind in social media? First is get back to being social on social media. It's time to hit not just the like button, but actually leave a comment when you see that friend's post about their family vacation. Imagine the difference of just hitting the like where you get lost in the 80 likes that they got, or a comment that says, "Wow, the family photos look great. How was your vacation?" question mark. Do you think that's more likely to get a response from you? And if that person only responds, do you think that Facebook's gonna deem, wow, you two had a conversation, an interaction, and it's time to put you in front of them more often, and vice versa? That's one of the best strategies, just being social again. It's time to get back to that, because that's really where it all started, was connecting with people around the world. It's time to keep connecting with them. And to do this systematically, your next tip would be to create lists and groups of people that you can interact with. So taking your friends, and if you have like 1,700 friends like I do, it's hard to keep track of all my clients in that. Yet I can create a list of clients that can keep them together. So when I want to strategically communicate with them, I can choose a day, time block, right? And then I can go into that list and be purposeful about commenting and sharing their post if they have Girl Scout cookies they're selling, or if they have something that they're asking for, who do you know who has a plumber, right? It's about the connections, getting back to your relationship. And the final tip I would give you, if you really want to take advantage of this, is Facebook Live. It's time to get rid of that shyness in front of the camera and do a video like I'm doing right now. Get in front of those people and share your tips. So a great way that you can do a video that would be helpful to the clients and would also drive traffic to your website. Imagine writing a blog of the top 10 ways to stage your home and then doing a video that talks about three of those strategies. You could do something like, "Hi, this is Jay Cermak, your local realtor, and I'm going to give you three tips to stage your home." Give the three tips, and then for more information, visit my website, and then I have an additional 7 tips that will help you stage your home. That way you're giving value on Facebook, and you have an opportunity for that person to click on it and visit your website because they can read the full blog if they choose to. Well, at the end of the day, Facebook wants to keep people more on Facebook and in that system. That will still allow you an opportunity to give value, be seen as an expert that people can look at and stay inside Facebook, and if they choose to, they can go to your website. Now, those are just three strategies that will really help you in 2018 with Facebook. Stay tuned. I'm going to be doing a masterclass on how to post the right content and what to do, and I'm going to be sharing it here on Katie But Connect for all the amazing agents. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, please give it a like. Leave me a comment down below. I'd love to hear from you, and follow me on Katie But Connect today.